that, as you can see behind me, is the type night that we had last night. So myself and Andrew got out here and started thrashing on this car. We've been working on this car for weeks and weeks and weeks now, like every single night. Last night, we had a bunch of stuff we wanted to do to the car, and honestly, I just didn't even want to video. I didn't feel like videoing. We had so much to do, so we just jumped on this thing and got it done. And it's a good thing that we didn't video, because it took us, I don't know, like 6 hours to do what we had to do, and it really only should have taken like 2 or 3 at the most, but that's the way it goes sometimes. Anyway, I'm going to turn the camera around and show you guys what we did last night, and then we'll talk about the car a little bit more. So as you can see, a few things have changed here. Not really a whole lot. We decided last night, the obvious is the intake. So we decided last night we'd go ahead and put our Edelbrock intake on. We've been saving this for the 347, but last night I pulled the GT40 intake off, the Explorer intake. It is over here. Pulled it off last night, and because it was, you know, it was horrible, and decided I was gonna paint this thing. Well, I didn't realize it was so jacked up. So this thing is just so chewed up, guys. Look at that. So shot a little bit of paint on it, started fisheyeing, all that just didn't work out. So I was like, all right, let's go ahead and get this other intake put on. So we started. And guys, Lord, the trouble we had with this is just beyond belief. But long story short, we got it done. And as you can see, we kind of cleaned up some things. Well, you probably can't see, but I got rid of the heater tube that runs across right here, because honestly, we're never gonna run the heater in this car. As long as I've had this car, we've not had a heater and it's been perfectly fine. It doesn't get that cold down south, and this car's not gonna be going on like vacations and long trips and stuff like that. So we just went ahead and left that out and cleaned it up. Down here, let's see, you can see right in there, I basically cut the snout off and welded everything up tight. So that way we don't have to worry about that. Looped the water pump back around on itself. Also did a few things underneath the car with some wire loom and just kind of touched some things up. But anyway, I'm about to pull the car out and we're going to try to burp the system on it. So let me go ahead and move some things around. Let's get this car backed out and see if we can get this thing burped. Also, as you can see, we had some bad weather yesterday. Yeah. Trees. Look, we just got a bunch of trees removed, so I guess that's a good thing, because it probably would have been a lot worse. But we got just stuff everywhere, guys. It got so bad. It broke my fence in like 3 or 4 different spots, over there, big limbs all in the yard. But you know, overall, could have been a lot worse. And these were just like straight line winds that came through. Anyway, I cleaned most of it up for the most part. So yeah, it was a bad day yesterday. Andrew put his new gas tank in, and as you can see right through there, see that bolt? That was actually pretty loose. So Andrew's just coming in right now and checking everything. The truck stalled out on him a couple times. So
it stalled out on me at the gas station, and the first thing I thought about was, or I tried to crank it back up at the gas station, didn't want to crank. So the first thing I did was pop the hood and look at the fuel pressure gauge after the fuel pressure. So I knew it was either the ground, I knew I left something loose, either the ground that goes to both of the pumps or the power wire that goes to both of them. And luckily it wasn't on top of the tank. I left that one right there a little loose.
We think that's it anyway. If not, then it's gonna be a connection inside the tank. It's not the end of the world, guys. So hopefully that's it. That's the problem. So Andrew is gonna be trying to take this truck to Ford Takeover, but we still got a lot of work to do, guys. We gotta buff this thing. We gotta lower it. Front end is, boy. I mean, that's the style though, Andrew. I will give you that though.
The style for who? I don't get a discount when I eat at Golden Corral, man. That's not the style for me.
Look at Andrew's mufflers. Andrew, this thing sounds so good.
Oh my God, it sounds like a log truck.
Yeah, it sounds really, really good. So we're gonna have to do something about that at some point. Or somebody's gonna have to do something about it. I don't know if we are.
Yeah.
You wanna come hold the phone so they can hear this thing knock?
Not really.
All right, look, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna fire this thing up.
In front of the camera.
We're gonna fire this thing up, and I wanna show you the sound that we're having. Like it's a dead misfire. So it almost sounds like the engine's knocking, but I think it's the cutout over here. The cutout's
just flapping back and forth.
Yeah, flapping.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that ain't a knock. I'm pretty sure that's just that cutout.
Yeah.
Flapping back and forth.
Yeah, that's what we think anyway.
We know it's a hunk of junk.
So. Yeah, so it sounds like that cutout. Yeah, it worked pretty good for a little while. But that cutout basically just flops around, so that could be it. I really don't think it's a knock, but it could be. If it is, though, we're going to go ahead and throw this new motor in with these heads, with the those LMR SVE 170cc heads. We're going to throw those on, and the only thing that we're going to do is upgrade the valve springs. So we have the AFR 185s, but we're not going to be able to run those right now, and I'll show you why. They need a little bit of work, so that's not something that I'm comfortable just lapping out. So they need to be sent to the machine shop to really be checked out. So with all that being said, we can run these valve springs right here, though, which are really good valve springs. So if we do have to put the new motor in, we're just going to go to these valve springs right here. Should be the same thing. Should work just fine. Those springs were set up pretty much for the exact same cam that was in Justin's motor before. Update. I didn't shoot any video, but we found the front passenger side shock or strut not even attached to the A-arm, like completely pulled out, no nut on it, no nothing. That's crazy. So that's going to definitely tighten this truck up a lot and probably help it hook. Now, we did go ahead and tighten all the suspension up on it.
That is 110% better.
Yeah.
But dude told me when I bought it that it's got QA1s on the front and strange adjustables on the back.
Yeah.
People told me when I bought it, they were all the way loose. So I kind of just attributed it to that. And then when I took the wrinkle walls off of it and put these on it, it was tenfold better.
Yeah.
And it was still a little wavy, but I always just attributed it to the fact that all the shocks were all the way loose.
Just the way it rides from right here. And we'll probably loosen up the back a little bit. We just tightened it up really tight for right now.
Yeah, just to see if it worked.
Yeah. I guess I should have videoed it, but shock wasn't attached to the top. That's all you guys need to know.
Yeah.
But nothing was hurt. There was a C-clip off of it. We got that back on. So I think we'll probably loosen up the back a couple clicks. That should, you know, soften it up a little bit because it's actually really stiff now.
Yeah.
So no body roll or anything like that. It's actually really stiff. So hopefully we don't have any more pump issues. I think Andrew found the problem there. So.
It really needs to be retuned to get rid of that aggravating high idle.
Yeah, I don't know what the deal is.
The tune on this truck, I don't think, was ever fully completed. I don't think. The truck supposedly makes good power, but I'll believe it when I see it get put on the rollers. I mean, yeah. I know it makes good power, but I just don't know if it makes that much.
We'll go ahead and wrap this one up. I just wanted to share with you what we were doing. We've been really grinding, getting after it the past few days, and I've just not videoed everything, but just know that we're in the background working our asses off. We really are. We're getting after it, guys. There's just, you don't want to see but so much of this type of content where we're working on stuff and stuff breaks and it doesn't work and we're like, it's every single day something's wrong. So that, you know what, sometimes we'll just talk about it and roll on from there. But anyway, Andrew's truck's doing good at least. Now it's time to get back on the Calypso, figure out what's going on with it. And I'll get back to you guys. I'll see you in the next video. And as always, thanks for watching. watching.